Good morning, brothers and sisters.
主日平安.
Peace be with you.
真的是很高兴能够在主日跟大家一起来敬拜神.
I'm so glad to be here to worshiping God together with you today.
去年我太太为了一场夙愿.
Last year, my wife fulfilled a long-time dream.
她答应了朋友们邀请她去参加了绘画课.
By accepting the friend's invitation to attend a painting class.
她凭着一股热忱每天开始画水彩画.
And driven by an enthusiasm, she began painting watercolors every day.
从水果、树木画到风景、海滩.
Depicting everything from fruits and trees to landscape and beaches.
画出她心里想要表达的东西.
Expressing what she felt in her heart.
姑且不论她画得怎么样.
And regardless of how well she painted.
但是我个人觉得她可以自己 抒发一下自己的观察跟想法还是不错的。
And I personally think that it's great that she could express her observations and thoughts.
所以有一次我就调侃地问她说,
Once I teasingly asked her,
你的画画到底是属于哪一派?
Which school does your painting style belong to?
是表现主义派还是印象派?
Is it expressionism, impressionism?
还是其他的派别?
Or another school.
你知道最后的答案是什么吗?
Do you know the final answers?
她说是桂花派。
And she says, of course, it was the Kuihua school.
谈到了画画的风格, 大家可能对19世纪的 Claude Monet不陌生。
And speaking of painting style, you might be familiar with Claude Monet from the 19th century.
根据维基百科, 他的画作印象日出。
And according to Wikipedia, his painting, Impression Sunrise.
遭到了学院的攻击, 并且被杂志评论家路易月华挖苦为印象派。
It was criticized by the academic art community and was mocked by the critic Louis Leroy.
印象派的名称就因此而生。
Who coined the term Impressionism from it.
印象派的画作着重于描绘自然的刹那景象，强调主观的诠释。
Impressionist thinkings focus on capturing fleeting moments of nature and emphasize subjective interpretation.
从某个角度来看，我们大部分的人大多可以说是印象派。
In a way, most of us could be considered impressionist.
我所谓的印象派不是指你喜欢印象派的画画。
By impressionists, I don't mean those who love impressionist art.
而是说我们常常会先入为主的主观观念来左右我们对人的看法跟反应。
But rather those who often let preconceived notions shape our views and reaction to others.
这就是我所说的印象派的意思。
And this is what I mean by being impressionist.
当你的对人的看法和反应是根据你的主观印象的时候, 它有时候是会偏差的。
When your views and reactions towards others are based on subjective impressions, they can be biased.
我举个例子来说,
For example,
几年前我从台湾探亲回来,
And a few years ago, I was returning from a visit to Taiwan.
在飞机上的旁边坐了一位女士,
And on the plane, I sat next to a lady.
我看到, 他看到我在看一本周同培牧师所写的书。
And the lady saw me reading a book by Pastor Zhou Tongpei.
叫做问题教会问题。
With the title, The Problem Church Problems.
他就问我说,
And she asked me,
你是牧师传道人吗?
Are you a pastor?
我回答说不是。
And I replied no.
然后我很好奇地问她说, 你为什么这样说呢?
Then out of curiosity, I asked her why she thought so.
她回答说, 因为你在读有关教会问题的书。
She answered, because you are reading a book about church problems.
我那时候有点哑然失笑啊。
I couldn't help but chuckle.
原来自己给人造成错误的印象。
It turned out that I had given her the wrong impressions.
那么我们对我们自己的家人是不是也会有不太正确的印象呢?
So do we also have not quite accurate impressions of our own family members?
这个是有可能的。
And this is possible.
因为关系的亲近或者是从小就在一起。
Because our close relationships or because we have been together since childhood.
我们可能会以为自己的家人就是我们心中所想的。
We may assume that our family members are just as we think they are.
是那样的平凡毫无特别之处。
Ordinary and unremarkable.
这样的印象可能都是我们眼中的良目或者是白内障。
Such impressions could be the beams in our eyes or our cataracts.
当我们存着偏见去对人对事的时候，我们就会像中文成语所讲的，一叶障目，看不清。
When we approach people and situations with prejudice, we might, as a Chinese idiom says, miss the forest for the trees.
所以今天我想借由马可福音的六章一到六节来跟大家分享。
That's why today I would like to share the message from Mark chapter 6, 1 to 6.
不只是家人。
Titled Not Just Family.
我想用两个问题来跟大家分享。
I want to share with you with two questions.
第一个就是你是耶稣的家人吗？
First one is, are you a part of Jesus' family?
第二个是耶稣只是你的家人吗？
And second one is, Jesus merely a member of your family?
我们来看第一个问题。
Let's look at the first question.
你是耶稣的家人吗？
Are you a member of Jesus' family?
首先我们来定义一下什么叫做家人。
First, let's define what family means.
一般认为家人是指有亲属关系的人。
And generally, family refers to people with kinship ties.
这可能是因为血缘，如父母、兄弟、姐妹。
Which could be due to blood relations like parents and siblings.
那也有可能是因为婚姻，就像夫妻一样。
Or through marriage like spouses.
所以家人也称为亲人或是家里人。
Thus family members can also be called kinsmen or household members.
但是请注意，中文的家里人跟家里的人有时候是不一样的。
But note that in Chinese, 家里人 that means family members, and 家里的人 which is people in the house, can sometimes mean different things.
比如说住在家里会照料年长或生病所请来的看护。
For example, a caregiver is hired to look after an elderly or sick person in the house.
他们可以说是家里的人，但不一定是家里人。
They could be considered.家里的人 the people in the house, but not necessarily 家里人 which is a family members or family.
你知道我们这样的区分是因为用亲属关系来看的。
Because this distinction is based on our kinsmanship.
圣经对家人的定义除了有亲属关系的家人以外还有神的家人。
The Bible decides family not only in terms of kinship, but also spiritually at God's family.
当然，神的家人是用属灵的关系来定义的。
And in God's family is defined in spiritual way.
当我们相信耶稣，接受他成为我们个人的救主的时候，圣灵就重生了我们。
When we believe in Jesus and accept Him as our personal Savior, the Holy Spirit rebirths us.
使徒保罗说，我们可以呼叫神为阿爸父。
The Apostle Paul said that we can call God Abba Father.
并且圣灵与我们的心同证，我们是神的儿女。
And the Spirit testifies with our spirit that we are God's children.
使徒约翰在约翰福音一章十二节也写道：“凡接待他的，就是信他名的人，他就是他们权柄做神的儿女。”
The Apostle John also writes in John 1:12, "Yes, to all who did receive him, to those who believed in his name.He gave the right to become children of God.
这是不分种族、年龄、性别或者身份地位的应许。
This promise is irrespective of race, age, gender, or status.
只要相信耶稣，就是神的家人。
As long as you believe in Jesus, you are part of God's family.
在腓利门书有一个很好的例子。
The book of Philemon provides a great example.
腓利门书描述了保罗为了一位奴隶阿尼西姆代求而写信给他的同工腓利门。
Paul writes to his co-worker Philemon on behalf of a runaway slave, Onesimus.
腓利门是保罗带领归主的，他的家道丰富，在家中有教会。
Philemon, a wealthy man whose home housed a church, was converted by Paul.
阿尼西姆则是从腓利门家逃出来的一个人。
Onesimus, on the other hand, was a slave who had escaped from Philemon's house.
然而保罗对腓利门说，阿尼西姆是他在捆锁中所生的儿子。
Yet Paul refers to Onesimus as my son, whom I have begotten while in chains.
所以很明显的，保罗是从属灵的角度来说的。
Clearly, Paul speaks from a spiritual perspective.
因为都是相信耶稣，所以保罗和奴隶阿尼西姆还有富豪腓利门都成为神的家人。
Indicating that through faith in Jesus, Paul, Onesimus, and Philemon all become members of God's family.
所以一个很关键的问题就要问我们自己。
That's the key question we need to ask ourselves.
那就是我是不是耶稣的家人？
Am I part of Jesus' family?
今天经文的第一节说，
The first verse of today's scripture said,
他说耶稣离开那里来到自己的家乡，门徒也跟从他。
Jesus left there and went to his hometown, accompanied by his disciples.
这一节经文告诉我们，耶稣在门徒们的陪伴下离开了一个地方，回到自己的家乡，也就是拿撒勒。
This verse tells us that Jesus, accompanied by his disciples, left one place and returned to his hometown, Nazareth.
如果我们回到前面那一章，也就是马可福音第五章。
And if we look back at the previous chapter, Mark 5,
你就会看到，这是耶稣行了三个神迹以后，离开管会堂的埃鲁的家。
We see that this occurred after Jesus performed three miracles and left the house of Jairus, the synagogue leader.
他再一次回到家乡拿撒勒。
He returned once more to Lazarus.
如果是我的话，
If it were me,
我可能会不敢回去。
I may not dare to return.
因为在路加福音的第四章记载的拿撒勒人不光是撵耶稣出城。
And in the book of Luke, chapter 4, 28 to 29, he said not only will we drive Jesus out of town,
还要把他推下山崖去害死他。
But also want to throw him off a cliff to kill him.
但是出于怜悯跟恩慈。
However, out of mercy and kindness,
主耶稣明知有危险，仍然带着门徒们回家。
And Jesus, knowing the danger, still brought his disciples back home.
为的是希望他的家人跟家乡的人能够听到福音，得到拯救。
Hoping that his family and hometown people could hear the gospel and be saved.
今天的我们是不是也愿意像主耶稣一样？
Are we today willing to be like Jesus?
为了家人的灵魂而不畏艰险，
Not fearing difficulties for the sake of our family's souls.
或者如门徒们一样，愿意跟随主到底，
Or like the disciples, willing to follow the Lord to the end.
为主做见证，领人归主，
And testify for him and lead people to Christ.
这些都是值得我们思考，
And these are all worth pondering.
总而言之，家人是建立在关系之上。
In summary, family is built on relationships.
不管是肉体上的亲属关系，或者属灵的关系，
whether kinships or spiritually,
都是代表着一种紧密的连结。
And all this represent a close connection.
如果一个人在世上没有家人的陪伴，
a person without any family accompaniment in this world,
那感觉真的是很孤单。
Can feel truly lonely.
还记得我刚到美国读书的时候，
I still remember when I first came to the United States to study.
就感到举目无亲，难以适应。
I feel like a stranger in a strange land.
再加上自己离开学校到职场工作已经有一段时间。
And moreover, after leaving school for a while to work,
这个书本的知识早就忘了大半。
Most of the book knowledge had already been forgotten.
如今重拾书本，这课业的压力自然倍增。
Now, picking up the books again, the pressures of academics naturally multiplied.
在生活和功课的双重压力之下,
So under the dual pressures of life and studies,
常常感觉自己就像海中的孤舟一样,
I often felt like a lone boat on the sea,
不知道何时可以靠岸,
not knowing when I could dock.
这种感觉直到两年后桂华过来陪我才消失。
These feelings only disappeared 2 years later when Gui Hua came over to accompany me.
由此可见家人陪伴的重要性。
This showed the importance of having family around.
除了肉身的家人以外，属灵上的家人更让我们超越了血浓于水的狭隘思维。
Beyond physical family, spiritual family allow us to transcend the narrow thinking of blood is thicker than water.
即使是来自不同的背景、不同地方，或是不同的种族
，Even when we come from different backgrounds, places, or races,
仍然可以如有如家人般的感觉。
We can still feel like family.
也这也使我想到有晴天音乐世界的诗歌，叫做《我们成为一家人》。
This reminds me of a song from the Heaven Tunes International, titled "We Are One Family."
我相信大家应该都很熟悉。
I believe many of you are familiar with it.
因为几年前在中华联谊会的新年晚会上
Because a few years ago at the New Year Gala of the Chinese Fellowship,
我们教会的弟兄姐妹就用这首诗歌做了一个很生动的表演。
Our church brother and sister performed a lively act based on this song.
这首诗歌的歌词一直在重复一个词。
And the lyrics of this song repeatedly emphasize one phrase.
因着耶稣。
Because of Jesus.
他说因着耶稣我们成为神儿女。
It says, because of Jesus, we become God's children.
因着耶稣我们成为神国的子民。
And because of Jesus, we become citizens of God's kingdom.
最后一个。因着耶稣我们成为一家。
And the last one, because of Jesus, we become one family.
你们知道我们教会的名字叫主爱之家。
You know that our church name is House of Christ's Love.
也是因着耶稣而成为一家人。
And we become one family because of Jesus.
因着耶稣我们可以同享复活的生命。
And because of Jesus, we can share in the abundant life.
也因着耶稣我们可以同度人生的风浪。
And because of Jesus, we can navigate through life storms together.
希伯来书的作者这样讲。
The author of Hebrews, the book of Hebrews says,
他说耶稣他称我们为弟兄也不以为耻。
Jesus is not ashamed to call us brothers.
罗马书八章二十九节也这样讲，他说在神的家中耶稣就是我们的长兄。
And from Romans 8:29 also says that in God's family, Jesus is our eldest brother.
使徒彼得也告诉我们说，因着耶稣我们可以得着不能朽坏、不能玷污、不能衰残，为我们存留在天上的基业。
The Apostle Peter also tells us that because of Jesus, we receive an inheritance that can never perish, spoil, or fade, kept in heaven for us.
所以你们不觉得能够叫神的儿子耶稣是我们的长兄，是无比的光荣吗？
So don't you feel immensely honored to call Jesus?The Son of God, our eldest brother.
那么，亲爱的朋友们。
So dear friends.
那我再问你一次。
Let me ask you once more.
你是耶稣的家人吗？
Are you a part of Jesus' family?
如果还不是，我真的希望你能够尽快的相信他。
If not, I sincerely hope that you will believe in Him soon.
如果你已经是耶稣的家人。
If you are already a part of Jesus' family.
那你有没有想过你对他的认识究竟是到了什么程度呢？
Have you thought about how well you really know him?
你是还停留在风闻有你的阶段呢？
Are you still at the stage of heard about him?
还是已经跟约伯一样是在亲眼看到你的阶段呢？
Or have you, like Job, reached the stage of seeing with your own eyes?
我想大部分的我们可能都是在这两个阶段的中间。
I think both of us are somewhere between the two stages.
我们从耶伯记看到神的美意。
From the books of Job, we see God's promise, purpose.
他允许近前之人受到撒旦的攻击而经历苦难的试炼。
in allowing the godly to be tested by Satan and go through trials of suffering. However, this trial strengthens faith and draw us closer to God.
明白神的爱，以至于相信万事互相效力，叫爱神的人得益处。
And help us understand God's love, ultimately confirming that all things work together for the good of those who love God.
这也告诉我们。
This also tells us.
如果我们要能够亲眼看到神，就必须在人生的旷野苦难当中用心去体验。
That to see God, we must earnestly experience.Life in this wilderness of suffering.
况且神已经应许我们绝不撇弃我们无辜了。
God has already promised us that He will never leave us as orphans.
美国作家 Lina Abu-Jamra 曾经说
，American writer Lina Abu-Jamra once said,
我们往往会在旷野遇见神，并且成长。
We often encounter God in the wilderness and grow.
特别是在悲伤、失落和痛苦的艰难环境当中
，especially in difficult situations of grief, loss, and pain，
我们的信心会成长，会与神更亲近。
Our faith grows, and we will draw closer to God.
所以 ，Lina 的结论是
，So Lina has a conclusion.
人生的旷野并不是神的计划出了什么问题。
The wilderness of life is not a mistake in God's plan.
而是在成长的过程当中不可或缺的一部分。
Is an essential part of the growth process.
所以弟兄姐妹们
So brothers and sisters,
可能你从小就去教会
Maybe you have been going to church since you were young.
唱诗歌，参加主日崇拜
Singing hymns, attending Sunday worship.
或者你已经认识主耶稣多年
Or perhaps you have known the Lord Jesus for many years.
以至于你觉得耶稣一直就像自己的家人一样
And feeling that Jesus has always been a familiar family member.
平凡无奇
ordinary and unremarkable.
但是你有没有想过
However, have you think about this?
耶稣不只是你普通的家人而已
Jesus, is Jesus just a member of your family?
这就是我想跟大家分享的第二个问题
And this is the second question I want to share with you.
所以让我们先来看一下经文的二到三节
Let's read the scripture verse 2 and 3.
他说到了安息日他在会堂里教训人众人听见就甚稀奇说这人从哪里有这些事呢所赐给他的是什么智慧他所做的是何等的异能呢这不是那木匠吗不是玛利亚的儿子雅各约西犹大西门的长兄吗他妹妹们不是在我们这里吗他们就厌弃他
And the second verse, when the Sabbath came, he began to teach in the synagogue, and many who heard him were amazed. Where did this man get these things? They asked. What's the wisdom that has been given him? What are these miracles he is performing? Isn't this the carpenter? Isn't this Mary's son? And the brothers of James, Joseph, Judas, and Simon? Aren't his sister here with us? And they took offense at him.
有句俗话说你大十八变
and that's traditional sayings go a girl changes 18 times between childhood and womanhood
它表示从小孩到成年女孩子的外表容貌的转变
it means that from a child to an adult the change in a girl's appearance often too fast
常常快速的让熟悉的人都很惊讶
too fast that the people who are familiar with her are surprised
确实是如此、啊、
indeed
当我望着我家墙上挂着的家庭照
When I look at the family photos hanging on the wall of my house
我就看到自己女儿的变化
I notice a change in my daughter
其实外表容貌的改变并不只是发生在女孩子的身上而已
In fact, the change in appearance does not only occur in girls
男孩子外貌也会随着年龄增长而有所改变
The appearance of boys will also change with age.Although it's not as big as the change in girls.
但是人的外貌并不代表他的全部。
However, the appearance of a person does not represent all of him.
所以当我们以人的外貌来做判断的时候，我们就有可能成为负面印象派。
Therefore, when we judge by the appearance of a person, we may become negative impressionist.
会有偏见，会有成见。
And there will be bias and deviations.
使徒保罗在哥林多后书的五章十六节这样讲。
The Apostle Paul said in the 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 16,
他说，所以我们从今以后不凭着外貌认人了，虽然凭着外貌认过基督，如今 却不再这样认他了。
He said, from now on, we regard no one from a worldly point of view. Though we once regarded Christ in this way, we do so no longer.
这里的外貌在原文上是指肉体的意思。
And the appearance here in the original word is mean the physical body, in the original text.
也就是以自己的肉体眼光来看周遭的一切。
That means you look at everything around you with your own physical vision.
这包括以对方的外表、财富、学识、身份地位等等来做判断。
Including judging by the other's appearance, wealth, knowledge, and status.
这包括以对这个保罗清楚的来指出。
And Paul clearly point out.
当我们凭着肉体眼光来认人是很危险的。
It is very dangerous when we recognize people with the eyes of the flesh.
他自己曾经用这种方法来看耶稣。
He himself used to look at Christ in this way.
结果竟然不知道耶稣就是基督。
But he didn't know that what Jesus was the Christ.
是他们犹太人一直在等候的弥赛亚。
The Messiah the Jews has been waiting for.
因为如此他大肆地迫害信耶稣的门徒。
Because of this, he persecuted the disciples who believed in Jesus.
他以为这样做就是热心于祖宗的律法。
And thinking that doing so was to be zealous,about the Lord of his ancestors.
一直到在大马色的路上遇见了耶稣，他才幡然醒悟。
And then, until he met Jesus on the road to Damascus, he suddenly woke up.
我们在今天经文的二到三节。
In verse 2-3 of today's scripture,
我们看到耶稣的家人跟家乡的人也犯了同样的错误。
We see that Jesus' family and people in his family have made the same mistake.
他们一方面惊奇于耶稣的智慧跟行神迹的能力。
On the one hand, they were amazed by Jesus' wisdom and ability to perform miracles.
但是另一方面却是凭外貌认人。
But on the other hand, they recognized people by their appearance.
他们认为耶稣只不过是一个木匠。
They believed that Jesus was just a carpenter.
既没有上过什么名牌大学。
He had neither attended a famous university,
也没有拿过什么博士学位,
nor received a doctorate degree.
而且他是玛利亚的儿子。
Moreover, he was the son of Mary.
他的兄弟姐妹也都生活在他们那里。
And his brother and sister also lived with him.
既没有什么教育水平，也没有什么作为。
They had neither education nor anything to do.
因此他们就认为这样的家庭是不可能有什么出息的子女。
Therefore, they believed that it was impossible for such a family to have any promising children,
更不可能会有能够行神迹跟讲道的,
let alone people who could perform miracles and preach.
其实使徒圣经注释也指出,
and 使徒圣,
他说拿撒勒人将耶稣称为玛利亚的儿子, 其实是带有羞辱。
And the scriptures say they point out that the Nazarenes called Jesus the son of Mary, which was actually humiliating.
因为在犹太人的文化中，他们不会称男子为他母亲的儿子。
Because in Jewish culture, people do not call a man the son of his mother.
即使是他的母亲是一个寡妇。
Even his mother is a widow.
所以是除非是存心的想羞辱这个男子。
And that is deliberately trying to humiliate.Man.
虽然他们无法解释耶稣 为何会说出这么大有能力的话
although they could not explain why Jesus could speak such powerful words
而为何能够施行神迹奇事
and why he could perform miracles and wonders
他们还是执着地下结论说
and they still persistently concluded that
耶稣不可能是神所差来的他只不过是一个
That Jesus could not be sent by God. He was just an ordinary person.
这是从多么大的老花跟白内障。
This is such a big presbyopia and cataract.
以至于连耶稣都诧异他们的不信。
That even Jesus was surprised by their unbelief.
我们看到拿撒勒人的偏执。
The paranoia of the Nazarenes.
让我们看见人的硬心跟顽固不信，并不会因为见了神迹奇事而相信。
Allow us to see that people's hard-hearted and stubborn belief won't believe, even if they see the miracles.
其实从路加福音十六章的财主跟拉撒路的故事当中，我们就可以看到这样的例子。
From the story on the book of Luke, the story of the rich man and Lazarus, we can see the same example.
当财主要求亚伯拉罕打发逃犯的拉撒路到他父家去，对他的五个弟兄做见证。
When the rich man asked Abraham to send Lazarus, a beggar, to his father's house to testify to his five brothers,
以免他们来到阴间受痛。
So that they will not also come to this place of torment.
亚伯拉罕说,
Abraham replied,
他们有摩西和先知的话可以听从。
They have Moses and the prophets. Let them listen to them.
财主说, 我主亚伯拉罕啊, 不是的。若有一个从死里复活的到他们那里去，他们必要悔改。
The rich man said, "No, Father Abraham, but if someone from the dead goes to them, they will repent."
亚伯拉罕说，若不听从摩西跟先知的话，就是有一个从死里复活的，他们也是不听劝。
And Abraham said, "If they do not listen to Moses and the prophets, they will not be convinced, even if someone rises." From the dead.
另外一个相反的例子，我们回到约翰福音的第一章记载的。
And then the example in the Gospel of John, chapter one.
讲到了耶稣呼召门徒。
He talk about and Jesus called disciples.
其中讲到这个腓力被呼召以后，他找到他同乡的拿单业。
When Philip was called, he found his fellow countryman Nathanael and said to him.
对他说，摩西在律法上所写的和众先知所记的那一位，我们遇见的，就是约瑟的儿子拿撒勒人耶稣。
And Philip said, "We have found one, the one Moses wrote about in the law, and about whom the prophets also wrote, Jesus of Nazareth, the son of Joseph."
你们知道拿单业怎么回答吗
？Do you know how Nathanael replied?
拿单业对腓力说：“拿撒勒还能出什么好的吗
？”And Nathanael said to Philip, "Lazarus, can anything good come from there?"
腓力说：“你来看。
”Philip said, "Come and see."
这里请注意一下，腓力说耶稣是约瑟的儿子，而不是玛利亚的儿子。
Please note that Philip said here, "Jesus is the son of Joseph, not the son of Mary."
而且他邀请拿单业说：“你来看。
”Moreover, he invited Nathanael and said.Come and see.
所以虽然拿单业已经有先入为主的偏见，
although Nathanael already had preconceived prejudice,
但他并没有心硬不听，
he didn't listen.
他还是跟随腓力去见耶稣，
he still followed Philip to see Jesus.
也是因为如此，他才有机会认识到耶稣并不是他所想象的平凡人，而是神的儿子。
It was because of that, this, that he had the opportunity to realize that Jesus was not the ordinary person he imagined, but the Son of God.
这些都告诉了我们，当我们凭着肉体的眼光去看耶稣。
This all tells us that when we look at Jesus with the eyes of the flesh,
就会像俗话所说的，把他看扁了。
And as the sayings go, look down on him.
因为我们会把耶稣放在我们那无知的框架里。
Because we will put Jesus within the framework of our ignorance,
限制了他能为我们所做的
limiting what he can do for us.
当然，结果就是我们得不到他的恩典
And the result is that we will not receive his grace.
就像那些拿撒勒人一样
just like those Lazarenes.
由于厌弃了耶稣，所以耶稣就在那里不行什么异能，而往周围乡村去教训人去
Because they rejected Jesus.Jesus did not perform miracles there and went to the surrounding countryside to teach people.
这不是损失很大吗?
Isn't this a great loss?
也只有当我们愿意敞开心
Only when we are willing to open our hearts,
像拿单耶一样，愿意用心眼去观察去了解。
Like Nathaniel, be willing to observe and understand with our own eyes.
我们才能真正认识到耶稣的特殊。
Can we truly realize the particularity of Jesus?
他并不只是我们平凡的家人。
He's not just our ordinary family member.
其实你如果从今天的经文继续往下看。
In fact, if you continue to read from today's scripture,
你就会发现在第七节。
You will find that in verse 7,
耶稣叫了十二个门徒来，差遣他们两个两个出去，也赐给他们权柄制服污鬼。
Calling the 12 to him, he began to send them out two by two and gave them authority over impure spirit.
然后到了十二十三节。
And then you verse into verses 12 to 13.
门徒就出去传道，叫人悔改，又赶出许多的鬼，用油抹了许多病人，治好。
They went out and preached that people should repent. They drove out many demons and anointed many sick people with oil and healed them.
这说明了耶稣是蛮有神的能力跟权柄。
This shows that Jesus is full of God's power and authority.
他不是拿撒勒人所认为的仅仅是一个没有知识的木匠而已。
It's not what the Lazarene think. He's just a carpenter with little knowledge.
虽然他为了等同于我们而出生于约瑟的家庭。
Although he was born to Joseph's family to emphasize with us and work as a lowly carpenter.
从事于低位的木匠工作。
Yes, and work like a carpenter.
他既没有偷懒不做事。
He was neither lazy or ignorant.
他也懂得人间的疾苦。
And he also understands the sufferings of the world.
难怪希伯来书的作者说，他并非不能体恤我们的软弱。他也曾凡事受过试探，与我们一样，只是他没有犯罪。
No wonder the author of the book of Hebrews said that, for we do not have a high priest who is unable to empathize with our weakness, but we have one who has been tempted in every way, just as we are, yet he did not sin.
他是我们的大祭司。
He is our high priest.
是神跟我们之间的中保。
And the mediator between God and us.
我们绝不能对他等闲视之。
And we must not take him lightly.
好，让我做一点结论。亲爱的弟兄姐妹们
，Dear brothers and sisters，
神赐给我们家人来陪伴我们共度人生的喜怒哀乐。
God has given us family members to accompany us and spend the joys.
他们可能是我们肉身的亲属家人。
These are our physical relatives and family members.
也可能是我们属灵的弟兄姐妹。
Or they may be our spiritual brothers and sisters.
如果我们以为他们的陪伴是理所当然的。
If we take their company for granted.
甚至不懂得珍惜跟感恩。
And even don't know how to cherish and be grateful.
那我们就应该要多加反省。
Then we should reflect more.
另外，如果我们有时可能也会觉得我们自己的家人平凡无奇。
In addition, we may sometimes feel that our family members are ordinary.
其实家人在职场上或其他的领域上成就非凡。
Even though they have extraordinary achievements in the workplace or other fields.
就像夫妻结婚多年。
Just like a couple who has been married for many years.
早已看久了习惯。
Have seen each other for a long time and are used to each other.
想不出自己当初为什么那么的被他吸引。
They can't think of why they were so attracted to him or her in the first place.
不过有一个方法可以让人家人对你刮目相看。
However, there is one way to make your family impressed.
那就是相信耶稣。
That is to believe in Jesus.
成为他的家人。
And become his family.
因为他是万王之王，万主之主。
Because he is the King of Kings and Lord of Lords.
当你的家人看到你的生命的改变。
When your family, own family sees the change in your life,
自然会对你用新的眼光来看待。
They will naturally look at you with a new perspective.
对你重新的评价跟认识。
And we evaluate and understand you.
然后你可能会说我已经信主多年。
You may say that I have believed in the Lord for many years.
我的配偶对我已经太熟悉了。
And my spouse is already too familiar with me.
所以他不觉得我有什么特别的地方。
So I don't think there's anything special about me.
其实这都是盲点。
Actually, these are all blind spots.
太习以为常就很难看到对方的不平凡。
And it is difficult to see the other party's extraordinary if you are too accustomed to it.
即使弥赛亚也遇到了同样的问题。
Even the Messiah faces the same problem.
今天经文的第四节，耶稣对拿撒勒人说：“大凡先知，除了本地亲属本家以外，没有不被人尊敬。”
In the fourth verse of today's scripture, Jesus said to the Nazarenes, "A prophet is not without honor except his hometown, among his relatives, and in his own home."
当我们习惯于把耶稣只当作家人来看的时候。
When we are accustomed to see Jesus only as a family member,
我们就会忽略了他原来是与神同等的那一位。
We will ignore that he was originally the same as God.
他拥有全知、全能跟全在的本质。
He has the essence of omniscience, omnipotence, and omni.
既是慈爱怜悯，又是圣洁公义。
He is both loving and merciful.
是轻慢不得。
Holy and righteous, and cannot be despised.
他是我们的家人，但是也是我们生命的主。
He is our family, but he is also our Lord.
所以，愿我们每天借着读经祷告来亲近他。
May we get close to him every day through Bible reading and prayer.
领受他的活泼圣言。
We receive his holy word.
认识每个早晨都是新的他。
And know that every morning is a new him.
因为他的信实是确实。
Because great is his faithfulness.
谢谢。
Thank you.
我们先做个结束祷告。
And have a closing prayer.
亲爱的主，我们满心的感谢。
Our dear Lord, we give thanks to you.
因为你让我们知道，原来做你自己的兄弟姐妹是何等的喜悦。
For us to realize that it's such a joyful thing to be your brother and sisters.
是我们的家人，但是你也是我们一生的主。
You are a family member, but he's also a Lord of our life.
让我们每天都能够看见你自己的荣美。
Let us see your glory every day.
带领我们弟兄姐妹的一生一世。
And lead us in our whole life.
我们这样祷告，感谢奉主耶稣基督圣名。
And then we praise in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.